alright, baby, you bet. You know what I mean? One thing I did, mixed everything in. I got all my dry ingredients in here, wet ingredients. I got the batter ready for the red velvet cake, baby. I got my three square pans. It's gonna be a three layer red velvet cake. You know what I mean? I put the butter inside with the flour, non-stick edges. What we're gonna do next? Now, one little secret that I did, that I noticed that every time I watch Food Network and all these other shows, is that anytime they make it, any type of dough, any type of bread, donuts, whatever, they make that dough and they aggravate the dough. They make it aggravated. They stress it out. But they always give it time to rest before they actually bake it. So I was like, they do the same thing with cakes, but why I never see people let the cake batter rest? After they mix everything up, they put it in the pan. Got a lot of chemicals in it. Got a lot of things going on in there. Let it rest for a little bit. So what I did, you know, on our little break, I let it sit. I just let the cake sit for like 15 minutes, man. And it really makes it a little moisture. I've seen the difference in it. Don't tell me, it ain't no big difference, but all my cake's good, bro. I seen a little difference when you let that batter rest for like 10, 15 minutes before you actually pour it in the pan after you do all that meat. The beat on it. So I'm gonna pour it evenly in three pans. Here we go in the oven. Getting closer to the end, baby. You know what I mean? So guess what? In the oven. There's a little pan of water at the bottom. I hate cooking with
closing the oven to the heating.
One thing I hate cooking with is dry heat. You ever bake cookies, they have the dry edges. Bake a cake, cornbread, has the dry edges. I put some water in there and make some steam in there, get some moisture in the oven. It's still gonna cook. It's gonna take away all that dry edges and the crusty edges that you have on your cake, your cornbread, your cookies, whatever it may be. I'll never say you never teach you that, baby. So we're gonna go ahead and pour this evenly throughout the pans. Now, one thing that we're gonna do, we're gonna throw these in the oven. We're gonna bake these for about 20 or 25 minutes. And the reason why we're doing it 20 or 25, we got three layers, so it's thinner. Usually when you use two pans or silver cake or whatever, if it's two layers, you may do 35, 40 minutes. But it's thinner. So, let me taste that better. That's what I'm talking about. That's cake. Now to get that thing evenly around in the pan, you're just gonna shake it like that so it'll be even. You see that? And do that to all the pans. Just shake it. So I get it even, more cooling. I'm gonna scrape the rest of this. I don't like it really bad. So scrape the rest of this up and pour it on this last one. You know what I mean? So we're gonna throw these in for 20 to 25 minutes. We're gonna bring them out. We're gonna let them cool. Then we're gonna ice them up, baby. Hey, I'm gonna show you how to make the icing shortly. You know what I'm saying? So let's go throw these in the oven, baby. Now remember, a little pan of water up underneath. Put that in while you're preheating so that water can heat up and also create the steam. And throw these in the oven, baby. 20 to 25 minutes, baby. Once again, man, this is with Chef Mel, man. We're baking red velvet cakes. Y'all holler at me, man. That's how we doing. Fellas, get in the kitchen. Please, your lady, man. Keep a smile on her face. Or somebody else will.